So I will explain you systematically the different trigonometric ratios, and the most important part is that I will explain you how to remember them. So listen to this carefully. First I will write different trigonometric ratios, explain you, and then I will tell you how to remember. And once you understand this, you will remember these trigonometric ratios permanently. Okay, let us start with right angle triangle. You see here, ABC is a right angle triangle. And let us take angle A. This is angle A. Similarly, ABC is right angle triangle and angle marked is angle C. Now, the different sides of right angle triangle, here it is right angle 90 degree, are one is called hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse. The longest side of right angle triangle is hypotenuse. And the other two sides, one side that is along the angle is called adjacent side, and the other one which is opposite to the angle is called as opposite side. Now let us come to the different trigonometric ratios. The first trigonometric ratio is sine of angle A, which is written as sine A. I am taking with respect to this angle. Then cosine of angle A, which is written as in short cos A. Next is tangent of angle A, in short it is written as tan A. Next is cosecant of angle A, which is written as in short cosec A. Next is secant of angle A, is written as sec A. And the last one is cotangent of angle A, is written as cot A. Now we will see these ratios: sin A, cos A, tan A, cosec A, sec A, and cot A. Now first let us define sin A. Sin A is defined as opposite side to hypotenuse. Now what is the opposite side of angle A? It is BC. It is BC upon AC. AC is the hypotenuse. And next is cos of A is adjacent side. It is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. It is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Sin A was opposite side upon hypotenuse. Cos A is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is AC as it is in earlier case, and adjacent side is AB. So cos A is AB upon AC, that is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Now next is tan of A. Tan of A is opposite side upon adjacent side. It is opposite side upon adjacent side. And opposite side is BC and adjacent side is AB. BC upon AB. So that was about tan of A. Now cosec of A is actually, it is the 1 upon sine of A. It is 1 upon sine A. Cosec is 1 upon sine A. And sine A is opposite upon hypotenuse. So it is other way. It is hypotenuse in the numerator divided by opposite side. Divided by opposite side. That is equal to 1 upon sine of A. So it is inverse of this, that is AC upon BC. AC was in the denominator, I have brought it in the numerator, and BC goes in the denominator. Now sec of A is again 1 upon cos of A. It is 1 upon cos of A. So I can write this as hypotenuse divided by adjacent side. It is hypotenuse divided by adjacent side. That is inverse of cos. So it was AB upon AC. Now this is AC upon AB. AC upon AB. So that was up to sec of A. And cot of A is inverse of tan of A. It is inverse of tan of A. So tan A was opposite upon adjacent. Now this is adjacent upon opposite. So it is adjacent side upon opposite side. Adjacent side upon opposite side. And so it is inverse of tan. So it will be AB upon BC. AB upon BC. Now you see here, sine is opposite divided by hypotenuse, cos is adjacent divided by hypotenuse, tan is opposite upon adjacent. And further three trigonometric ratios are very easy to remember, because sec A is 1 upon sin A. So you inverse it. That is hypotenuse upon opposite side. Sec A is 1 upon cos A. Again you inverse it. So inverse of cos, it becomes hypotenuse upon adjacent side. So hypotenuse upon adjacent side. And cot A is 1 upon tan A. So again you inverse the ratio of tan. It will become adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent upon hypotenuse. These are the six ratios or the trigonometric ratios. Now how to remember them? So you have to remember them. So I will put it in the frame. You have to remember them easily. And there is very easy method to remember them. I will explain you. I will explain the easy method. So let me frame them first. So this part you have to remember perfectly. And there is a method to remember this. Okay, now how to remember that? Fourth part. It is S O S so. Then C A H car. And then T O A. It is the word saw, ka, to, ha. See, sine opposite hypotenuse. Sine opposite hypotenuse. Cos adjacent hypotenuse. Cos adjacent hypotenuse. And tan opposite adjacent. Tan is opposite upon adjacent. So you have to remember these trigonometric ratios by remembering this word called so ka to a. So ka to a. Remember this perfectly. So ka to a. Now there is another way to remember this. You can frame your acronym. See, the sentence is like this. She offered her child a heaping teaspoon of applause. Can you remember this sentence? Yes, it is very easy to remember this sentence. And once you remember this sentence, you take out the first letter of each word. That S O H C A H T O A. It becomes again so ka to a.